guys, Pastor Eric here from KFBC Kids. Welcome to day number 5. I am so glad that you're here today, and I hope that you've been having so much fun. Let me tell you, I cannot believe that we're already on day number 5. It seems like the whole month of July has just flown by. And did you have so much fun last week? And let me tell you, this week we're going to have a blast. We have a great lesson. We have a great craft. Miss Nicole is going to share with us about missions. We've got great music. And Miss Sarah has something very special for snack time with Miss Sarah. And listen, I don't know if you can believe it, but Miss Sarah and Miss Melissa, they beat us last week. Miss Sarah and Miss Melissa, you are the champions. Great job, guys. Well, hey, listen, let me tell you, we have a wonderful day in store for you today, and I am excited as you get to learn about Jesus, our strong foundation. Well, guess what? I'm ready to get to work. How about you? All right, our next stop for VBS is our motto and scripture. Have fun, guys, and we'll see you soon.
Hi, we're the Darville family.
We hope by now you've memorized our scripture and motto. Let's say the motto together now.
Jesus, our strong foundation.
And now with the hand motions.
Jesus, our strong foundation.
Now Matthew's going to read our verse.
I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Jesus Christ. Philippians 1:6.
D.I.Y. Blueprint Bible Study. I am Miss Carrie, and I am normally teaching the preschool kids at VBS, but this week I'm so excited to be here with you. Does anybody know what it means to be wise? To be wise is to make a good judgment on a decision. Before we start our Bible story, we're going to play a little game. And just like week one with Miss Abby, I'm going to have you go to one side of the screen or the other side of the screen. I'm going to give you a decision, and you're going to have to decide if it's wise or unwise. So everybody stand up. If you're by yourself or with your friends, everybody just stand up. So our first decision is walking in the rain without an umbrella. Would that be wise or unwise? Now, move either side of the screen if you think it's wise or unwise. Okay, your second decision is walking at a construction site without a hard hat. Would that be wise or unwise? What about this one? Wearing work boots when you're walking around rusty nails. Do you think that would be wise or unwise? All right, here's one more. What about if you were to use glue instead of nails to build a house? Do you think that would be wise or unwise? All right, good job, guys. So today, our story, we're going to be talking more about why, more about unwise and wise decisions in our Bible story. All right, boys and girls, we've been building on our foundation of Jesus's love all month. And today, our Bible story is going to be about building a house. But before we start, I'm going to go look in my toolkit and review what we've been learning about. So the first thing I find in here is a flashlight. And this reminds us that Jesus loves me regardless of my sin. Okay, let's see what else we have. The whistle reminds us that Jesus chose to die for me. Okay, let's see, we have these nails. And if you remember, these remind us that Jesus will always love me. Oh goodness, this one's a big one. All right, well, boys and girls, this is a big bag of sand and dirt, and we're gonna learn about this one today. We'll come back to it. Now, our most important tool in our toolkit is the very last one, and it's our Bible. It's God's true holy word. Everything in the Bible is true. The Bible reminds us that Jesus chooses to love me, and I can't earn it. There is nothing I can do. So now is the time. We're about to do our Bible story. I want you to go get your Bible. We're going to open up to the book of Matthew. And do you remember what book that's in the Old Testament or the New Testament? That's right, it's the New Testament. Go get your Bibles. Okay, boys and girls, today's Bible story is a parable. A parable is a story that Jesus would use to teach people about God. And if you remember, our story's in Matthew 7, verses 24 through 29. One day, Jesus was speaking to a crowd of people, and he told them a parable. We just talked about that. What that was. It's a story to help people understand about the kingdom of God. And in his parable, there were two builders, and he told the story to help them understand why it's so important to listen and obey God's words. So he began telling the story, the crowd, about people who hear God's word and who obey them and do what he says. And he said those people would be like a wise man. And he builds his house on a firm foundation. And that would be the rock. It's strong, a strong foundation. And so when the rain falls and the river comes up and the wind blows against the house, it will not fall because it has such a strong foundation. However, the people who heard God's word but did not listen and did not act on them were like the guy who built his house on sand. It was not a strong foundation. It was the unwise man. And so when the rain came and the rivers rose up and the wind blew, the house came crashing down. Now, this teaching of Jesus's amazed the people, and they loved hearing about what it was to be wise to listen and obey God's word, or to be unwise and to listen to God's word but not to do it. So boys and girls, this story is so important to remind us to listen and obey God's word. And then we will have a strong foundation no matter what happens in our life. We will be strong on the rock of God. So now we're going to pull out our activity book. So for our preschoolers, I need you to open up to page 12. And you're going to draw your own building on this foundation. And this foundation is a strong foundation. It says, Jesus helps me know how to live because you've been listening and obeying God's word. Now, for our older kids, I need you to pull out your activity book, and it's on page 12 as well. and you're going to be looking at some tools and inspecting which ones you think would make a wise choice to help build something, and other things are just not going to be helpful. So work on those. Don't go anywhere, because up next we're going to do under construction crafts with Miss Melissa.
Hi guys, and welcome to Under Construction Crafts with me, Miss Melissa. Today we're going to build a photo frame. So in your bag, you have a bag like this that has a brown house, a green roof, a gray rock foundation, two yellow shutters, two white pieces for our fence, and a magnet. All right, let's get started. So first, we're going to start with our brown house, and we're going to glue our yellow shutters on it. So open your glue, put a small amount. Hold on, the glue's not working. There we go. Okay, we're gonna put it one right here. And one on this side, like this. Then we're going to put this green roof, and it has sticky pieces, so pull off the white strips and then stick it to the top, like this. Okay, now we're going to take the little white pieces. One side is sticky and the other side isn't. So make sure you have the non-sticky side. And use your marker, and we're gonna draw lines. To make it look like fence pickets. Now, pull the sticky piece off and put it on your frame. Like this. Okay, now we're going to put our rock bottom. So pull the white sticky piece off, turn your frame upside down, and stick it to the bottom. Like this. Now, we're going to attach the magnet that's in your bag up top. And then we're going to use this marker, and we're going to put words on the rock at the bottom. I'm going to write VBS 2020. And then maybe you have a picture of you and your family from VBS this year. I'm going to use a picture of our children's ministry team, and I'm going to put some glue on it. And we're going to attach it right here. Perfect. So now we have made a wise builder photo frame. Like Miss Carrie taught us in our lesson, there were two men. One built his house on the sand, and the rains came and washed his house away. But one man built his house on a rock foundation that was strong. So this is what we have built, a wise builder photo frame. Now, everybody, let's stand up. Learn some new motions and sing Build My Life on You.
I am living in you.
Welcome back, boys and girls, to Blueprint Bible Study. The verse we've been working on all week is out of Philippians 1:6. It says, I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. And I believe that God did a good work bringing you to VBS all month. So now we're going to review our foundations. So if we remember, we are reminded that you are loved by God. And you can ask for forgiveness for all of your sins. And you are precious to God. And also, God keeps all of his promises. And then today, we learned that God's love is the foundation of our life. Let's review. Here's some questions. All right, so our first question is, what is a parable? A parable is a story that Jesus would use to teach people about God. Our second question is, which house has a strong foundation? The house that was built on a rock. And these are the people who listen and obey God's word. They have a strong foundation. And our last is a true or false. True or false, Jesus' love is the foundation for the rest of my life. True, boys and girls, Jesus' love is the foundation for the rest of my life. Now coming up next is Snacks with Miss Sarah.
Hello, boys and girls, and welcome back to Snacks with Sarah. Our last Snacks with Sarah, aren't you sad? But I'm so excited because today we are going to celebrate that Team Sarah won our Snack Attack games for the month against Team Eric. Yay! Okay, I have a special guest that's gonna pop in a little later to celebrate with me, but today we are going to make a concrete sundae to celebrate our win and to close out our Concretes and Cranes VBS for 2020. I hope you've had so much fun. So now we're going to start with all of my favorite sundae toppings. We've got some Oreos here. We've got sprinkles, caramel, chocolate syrup, whipped cream, and some fruit, and a cherry for the top. Okay, so let's get started. Today, you guys talked about the wise and foolish builder and how it's so important that we have a strong foundation. So it is so important that our base for our concrete today is strong. So we're gonna use ice cream. And my favorite flavor is homemade vanilla. And it has to be Bluebell, right? Do I have Bluebell fans in the house? So we're going to use our base for the ice cream. So I want you to scoop your ice cream and make sure you get a good scoop because we are gonna make a layered ice cream sundae today. Because when you're talking about faith, faith has lots of layers, and we learned lots of different layers this month. We learned about love, we learned about forgiveness and worth, how worthy we are of Jesus's love. We learned about his promise and how he promises to never leave us. And Miss Carrie today talked to us about the promise of life and the foundation of life and how awesome it is that we can have a life in Jesus Christ. So here's my base. It needs to be firm, and we're gonna add some toppings. So now for the fun part. You need to get some Oreos, and I'm gonna use some construction tools to help me make some crumbly cookie goodness. So now you need to get some goggles if you're working in the kitchen. Okay, here we go. All right, and now I'm gonna use a hammer, and if you need mom or dad's help, find them in the kitchen and use your hammer, and we're gonna crush up some cookies because I like lots of cookies on my sundae. Very good. Okay, now you want to grab your cookies, and we're gonna pretend like these cookies are not a firm foundation. They're like the builder who built his house in the sand, right? So we've got some cookie crumbles, and I want you to make sure that you can see all these layers in your sundae. Okay, done with the cookies. Now, we need to add some more foundation because there's no way that my other toppings are going to stand on this without some more foundation. So grab you some more ice cream. Make sure that it's firm. Whoops, firm. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I like bananas in my sundaes, and I like strawberries in my sundae. So I think you're gonna need to put your goggles on one more time because we're gonna cut up and use a kitchen knife, okay? So you may need mom or dad's help, but use your banana, open it up. Let me get my goggles again. Okay, so knife, we're gonna cut up little bitty pieces of our banana or strawberry, and I want you to layer them all nice and over your ice cream. Very good. Oh, I need some more. You can never have too many bananas. So, here we go. One more. All right, perfect. Can you see my layers here? Can you see? Oh, yes. Good firm foundation, my rocky cookies, and now I have another foundation of bananas. Okay, now, do you think we need some more ice cream? I don't know. Nope, no ice cream. We are gonna move straight on to the goodness whipped cream. All right, and I'm gonna ask my special guest to come in, pop in and say hi to you guys because she was on the winning team. Wave to my fans, Miss Melissa, and we're gonna give her a little squirt. Oh my goodness. Okay, your whipped cream. All along the top. Yes. Okay. I also love me some sprinkles. So we're gonna take the sprinkles all over my sundae. Good. Now, we're about to wrap up our Snacks with Sarah. And I want you to know that there's one important thing that goes on the top of our sundae, and that's the cherry. The cherry on your top. Guys, Jesus is the cherry on top. He loves you. He forgives you. You're worthy. He makes a promise that we're never going to be alone, and he is the author and foundation of life. So we're going to put our cherry on top. If you're a cherry lover, here we go. He's our cherry on top, and I want you guys to remember that he loves you always, and he's never gonna leave you. I have had so much fun doing snacks with you this month, and now I want you to stay tuned because Miss Nicole has our final missions moment. Bye!
Hey guys, Pastor Eric here. Thank you so much for watching Vacation Bible School with us during the month of July. I've enjoyed doing the welcome videos and doing the closes. I've enjoyed doing Snack Attack with Miss Sarah. Well done, Miss Sarah. Good job. And let me tell you, as a pastor, one of my opportunities is to ask you important questions like, what did God teach you during Vacation Bible School? Is he challenging you to do something new? Have you learned something new that's helped you grow in your faith? Maybe as you've learned about Jesus, our strong foundation, you've made a commitment to pray more. Maybe God has helped you to understand how big and how awesome, how strong his love is. Maybe you've decided after these 5 VBS lessons that you really want to make sure that you're reading your Bible more so that you can become strong in God's word. Maybe for the very first time, you've understood God's love through Jesus. And maybe you are ready to believe in Jesus for the very first time. Well, guys, let me tell you, if you've never asked Jesus to become your Lord and Savior, if you've never asked him to forgive your sins so that you can become part of God's family, guess what? You can do that. You can do that today. In fact, you don't have to be at a church in order to do that. You don't have to be with a pastor, with me, in order to do that. You can pray to receive Christ right where you are. You can talk to your mom and dad about that. You can talk to a friend about what it means to be a believer in Jesus Christ. If you have questions about what that means, we'd love to hear from you. We'd love for you to talk to your mom and dad about your faith. I'm going to put together another video. It'll follow this one after Vacation Bible School. It's called The ABCs of Becoming a Christian. And if you'd like to know more about what it means to become a Christian and how to do that, be sure to check that video out. In the meantime, enjoy the rest of Vacation Bible School, and we'll see you soon. Bye.
Welcome back with me, Miss Nicole, to our mission moments. I'm so glad that you chose to join us in our virtual DIY VBS. As different as it seems, I hope you've had a great time. I'm sad that it's gonna end, but I pray that you have a new foundation and a new love and acknowledgement of the Lord and of all the goodness that He has for you and for you that's it's inside you that you can give others. So let's recap a little bit, okay, about what we've learned and what we've talked about and where it's come from and what it's done for you. First, in the beginning of our week, we talked about our foundation of love. And where does that love come from? Well, it comes from Jesus, and it comes because He chose to give it to us, and that you can give it out to others because it's already inside of you and He's given it to you. And then on day two, we talked about the foundation of forgiveness and who can forgive. Well, let's talk about who forgave us first. Well, Jesus did. He forgave us first. And that He wanted us that no matter what we did and no matter where we were going, that He forgave us and that we could be able to forgive others. On day three, we learned about our worth, the foundation of worth. Who is worthy? Well, no one really. But the Bible says that He chose us and that He died for us and that we are worthy, that He chose us. And that is the best thing that we can do, is to make others feel that they are worthy also. And then on day four, we learned about the foundation of promise. He promised that He would never leave us and that He would never forsake us and that He would be with us always. What an awesome promise of our Father to give to us, that we would never be alone. Today, we're gonna talk about the foundation of life. Super excited, but you know what's coming up next? We're gonna find out what's happening in the Worthy family over in Italy on the other side of the pond. I'll see you in a minute.
Part of Italian life. Almost everywhere you go in the city, you hear street musicians play amazing music. The most famous music theorist of the Middle Ages, Guido Monaco d'Arezzo, was born right here in Arezzo. He is the inventor of the modern musical notation, do, re, mi. And this is actually his house.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti.
Nice, Ben. Also, you can thank Italians for helping to invent the guitar, organ, violin, and piano.
Our family works with a lot of volunteer teams that come from America.
And these volunteer teams love Jesus, and they want to share that love with the people they come in contact with.
These groups do all sorts of things like teach English camps, sports clinics, music classes, anything that they can do to build relationships with Italians and eventually be able to tell them about Jesus. My favorite thing to do is what we call store-to-store ministry. That's when volunteer teams go from store to store, visiting people who work there, and try to start a conversation about Jesus. When they have made a friend, they'll come back with a local believer who will share the gospel with them.
The store-to-store outreach has been a really awesome way to share Jesus with Italians. Italy is a beautiful place with a rich history and a wonderful place to live. But there are a lot of lost people here who need to know that Jesus loves them and He wants to have a relationship with them. And that's why we are here.
There are people all over the world that need to know about Jesus, maybe in your hometown or neighborhood. We want to encourage you to reach out and make friends with those around you. And who knows, maybe you will get an opportunity to tell them about the love of Jesus. Please pray for us and we'll pray for you. And remember, as we say in Italian, Gesù ti ama. Jesus loves you. Ciao.
I am so grateful for the Worthy family and all the things that they are doing in Italy, that they get to share the love of Jesus and all that they are doing. But it's not just in Italy, it's all over the world that people need to hear about Jesus. And if it's all over the world, that means it's all over where you live also. And that you can be the missionary in your hometown, in your home, in your place that you play, and you can tell others about Jesus. And it is about our lives that we can place everything that Jesus has put inside of us and we can give it to others. So I am so sad that it is ending, and I am so sad that we're not going to be together again. But the great thing is that we are going to touch people's lives with the love and the promise and the worthiness and the forgiveness and the grace that Jesus has given us. And we are going to love one another, and that way we can see each other again. I am so glad that you spent your time with us, and I pray that your summer goes great. See you again. Bye.
It had been a hard week for Enzo. His building construction was getting beat bad by Foreman Nehemiah's project. He had been demoted and humiliated in the press.
Extra, extra! Boy genius of fraud! Poor choices ruined building!
And worst of all, he had lost his prize. A brand new Kids Colossal Bible Club on the 34th floor to help children learn about Jesus. Times were so tough for Enzo that his mum and dad had come to his side. But what he didn't know was that his prayers would soon be answered in the middle of the biggest challenge he had ever faced.
I still don't understand how they built this so fast.
Because they didn't hire a kid to be their architect. Next time I get a grand idea, do me a favor and stop me.
Well...
Zip it, Santiago.
I don't like the looks of that storm.
Lloyd, find some rain gear. It's gonna get wet.
Lloyd, you're always so prepared.
Well, well, well. Look who showed up to lose.
Your team's building has defeated Renzo Tower as the world's tallest building. So, on behalf of Kitten Construction, Inc.
Wait, Mrs. Kuhas.
Yeah.
These blockos. This is Renzo's design. He didn't get the math wrong. Foreman Nehemiah stole our blockos.
Oh, really? Huh? What? Can you prove it?
Yeah. It says Renzo's patented blockos all over them.
Well, no one will care. All anyone will remember is that this is the strongest building ever built by Foreman Nehemiah!
Whoa!
Fellas!
It might rain.
If this wind and rain keeps up, the water will get into the base.
Should I gather two of every animal?
Why didn't you build a firm foundation?
So we could beat Renzo.
Oh, people will remember this building, all right.
Oh, that looks like fun.
Renzo, what's happening?
They skipped the foundation.
No foundation means...
They go bye-bye.
We have to do something!
You can't exactly give them a hand, son.
Not just a hand,
a whole arm! I'm going to the crane! Dad, take a wrench and loosen as many girders as you can!
I'm on it. You really are prepared.
Lefty Lucy.
Hang on, people! Woo-hoo!
world's greatest architect builds world's best building. Get your paper!
As president of Kitten Cobra Construction, it is my honor to commemorate the grand opening of Friendship Towers, a revolutionary new concept for city living. Anything you want to add, young man?
Please, build your life on a strong foundation.
Yes, that's the story of Renzo Wright and the greatest truth we can ever learn. Jesus' love is the foundation for the rest of our lives. Oh, and if you're wondering, Renzo got his kids' colossal Bible club to help teach other children to learn about Jesus. So remember, he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion.
Extra, extra! Boy Genius opens Kids Colossal Bible Club to help children all over the city! Read all about it! Get your paper!
Who needs a name badge?
Thank you, Lloyd. Always so prepared.
Hey guys, how was our last day, day number 5? I hope you had fun today learning about Jesus, our strong foundation. Well, let me tell you, I want to make sure that we give a big thank you to all of our volunteers and all of our helpers who did all kinds of video planning and work to make sure that VBS DIY style was a success this year. We couldn't have done it without everyone working together. Well done, guys. You have been quite the crew. I want to thank you guys for tuning in. I hope you've had a great time. And more importantly, I hope you have learned a great deal about God and about His love and about Jesus, our firm foundation. Well, guys, I'm going to close this in a final prayer. Please bow your heads. Heavenly Father, God, we love you and we thank you that you are our strong foundation. Father, we're excited about all that the boys and girls have learned about faith and about your love and your forgiveness and eternal life. And God, I pray you help them to grow stronger in their faith each and every day. God, we love you. We thank you. Amen. Well, all right, guys. Well, hey, listen, we have some pictures to share with you of Vacation Bible School and all the helpers. I hope you enjoy them. God bless, and we'll talk to you soon. See you next year. Bye.